peace for life. I'm Mercedes Wilson, and I have Suzanne with me. And oh my gosh, let me tell you, this one brings out the kid in me. I don't know what it is, but this is bringing out the fun, spunky. Listen, I'll let Suzanne do most of the talking. So we have a charcuterie board here. Oh my gosh, the process. Can you start talking about the process, the ease that you can do this while I eat?
Absolutely, absolutely.
Let's talk about the items on the board. Let's start there.
Yeah, absolutely. So on a charcuterie board, you basically want to have a few different types of cheeses. I always like to include a soft cheese, a semi-soft cheese. So this is a Gouda, this is a Brie, and then I have kind of like an aged, almost like an aged cheddar. It's a Vino Rosso. So you want a hard cheese as well. So as long as you incorporate those three, it gives nice texture and options for people to choose from. And then your next item would be going towards your meat, your cured meat. So salamis are great, a Genoa salami or a dried salami are going to be great on boards. And then I always like to include maybe a little bit of pepperoni. We have some prosciutto. So I'd like anywhere from 3 to 4 meats, you know, up to 5 cheeses, 6 cheeses even as well.
Yeah, and can we stop at the meat? Because I would love for people to see the simplicity and how you made, you call this a river.
Yes, a salami river.
Yes, so the simplicity that people are seeing right now on how to make this, and the, is that called the salami rose?
The salami rose, yes.
And then the cucumber rose, and this is so simple to make.
Yes.
And it's a family activity. Like, yes, you can do this with kids.
Absolutely.
Right?
Yeah, I've taught my girls how to make anything on this board that can help me put together. I come from like a long line of chefs and artists, actually, so I think I kind of got both in me. And I just love how this board gives, you know, it's very versatile and gives options for your dinner parties. So people have a lot to choose from. And I love how it's got its own little story to tell. It's a great conversation starter.
Listen, this board took you how long?
To make, 15 minutes.
This is good.
Isn't that delicious? Nice and creamy, and then you've got the
olives,
sweet from the honey.
Talk about balancing the board with colors and how you do all of that.
Right, so I like to have a lot of color. I use tons of pops, so you want to have, if you have reds over here, you want to add a little bit of red over here, just to balance things out a little bit. You always want to have a little bit of dried fruit in there, and then just play with your colors. Move things around if you don't like the way that it looks, and then you can also play with however you've positioned things as well to just get it, you know, perfect, and so that you've got great combinations for people to choose from.
So tell me this, Suzanne. If life were a big bowl of seasonings and different ingredients that make up life, that make a good life, give me an ingredient that needs to be added that would make life good.
Family. I mean, family and friends. Like, I can't survive without my family and friends.
That's a good one. And that's a good way to end this Recipes for Life. Make a charcuterie board, first of all, and do it with your family, like you do.
Yes.
Involve your friends and family in your life and in the things that you're doing, and do something fun like this that brings out the kid in you, right?
Right.
Brings out the fun part, the creative, the artsy part.
Right.
Because that truly is one of the recipes for life. Thank you so much for joining us.
Woohoo! Delicious Recipes for Life. We are bringing the food to you this morning. Thanks so much to Mercedes Wilson. If you want to find out more of her recipes, then head online to MercedesEWilson.com and get more.